Could you tell us a little bit about how the fishing industry is being impacted by the climate change and other activities caused by people?
First of all, climate changes. I'm not really a fan of this this terminus, but definitely changes in the weather that we can see and feel every day impact on the way how we can work in the fish farms, but also on the fishing in general, in traditional fishing. So it's definitely more and more challenging, and not just because of the climate changes, but we can see migrations of fish which maybe we didn't see before. We can see that there are some fish which were interesting before, also commercially, we don't find so much anymore, so we can see them. It's definitely a big influence.
And what about any other activities by people, by humanity?
For me, generally, I always say that we put a lot of pressure on the sea. So we have tourism, we have transports, we have fishing, aquaculture, all the sewers, all the, you know, all the activity that people make on land, they actually influence also the sea. And in general, what we do, we think that the sea is so big and so vast, so whatever we do, we don't really take care of it so much. So in general, it's a negative, quite a strong negative effect, and we are just recently maybe starting to understand that we will have to take care of the sea.
Could you tell us a little bit about fish farms? What are they and how they function?
Fish farms are actually very similar like on land farms. In general, it's we have quite many different forms of farms. There are less and less wild fish in the sea, so we are trying to ensure food for the growing population, and farms are one of the options.
So what can we do as individuals or as consumers to help combat negative effects connected to fishing?
Okay, so you know, it's first of all, we need to realize that it's actually that everybody counts. So it's not, you know, that if you do something it won't be important, it's really important. So in connection with fishing, one of the things is that we need to realize that the sea offers us really immense diversity. So we can select different species. It's really important not just to be stuck on one. So, you know, if we say, okay, tuna is good, and then we just eat always tuna. But let's try to be, you know, to be imaginative. So let's go to the fish store, to the market, and think about, oh, maybe I could try this fish I never saw before. Maybe it would be good. And in this way, you help the fishermen, you help the sea. You know, it's not necessary that we always eat just big fish, we can eat smaller ones. And even if they say that they are less value, maybe, you know, it's something interesting. Or try to eat shellfish, which are also really sustainable in a way, how they're produced. And the other thing is also try to think about when you buy, whatever you buy, it's really, you give support to the producer. So it means if fish comes from aquaculture, try to select the ones which are produced in a more sustainable way, but try also to find the fish farms which are good for you. So it means that you like believe in the producer, you believe in the farmer, and give them support. So it means every single time that you go to buy something, you actually vote for that.